So.
And you cannot talk, you guys want to talk, you cannot talk.
85.
You can't even be here for 5 minutes?
We've been telling them that for almost 2 years, they short memory, short-term memory. I know, right? Oh, my. We're down here because they were trying to do what you're supposed to do, so we have to keep coming back because they hope that we're going to be back. That's why you're here. Mine is. I'm not an elected official. I know it's been a little bit on the way. It's kind of shocking.
Okay. Start public comment with pledge.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Keep your comments for 5 minutes. And come up to the front and give name and...
Can I do that now? Yeah, okay, great. Up here or here?
Just right.
Okay, great. My name is Rochelle Fuller. I'm with Senator Grassley's office out of the Cedar Rapids area. Tama is one of the counties, one of the 14 counties that I cover. I like to come to the supervisor's meetings so that I can let you know, or whoever might be here, what we do. So any federal agency, SBA, veterans, we help our veterans a lot. Helping them with medals, helping them with benefits. We are the contact sometimes if they can't get it through elsewhere. IRS, but any of the federal agencies. So as I was telling the gals over here, you would fill out a form on the Grassley website. And what we do is we make an inquiry for you. So passports have been big right now, people trying to get their passports. But I just want to, it's so important that you are aware, because you might get phone calls. I'm sure you guys get phone calls all the time. So I can come out here for different events, for meetings, like I'm going to leave here in about 15 minutes, but I wanted to say hello and thank you, and thanks for letting me speak.
Awesome, thank you.
Thank you.
So There's some wish list stuff in there to my race shop, but. No money, no.
Nothing wrong with the wish list.
Sharing all that wrong.
Yeah. Sometimes that's the problem.
Morning, Gary. I got a fly attack. You hear me preach a lot, but.
Quick question for you, Bill, concerning the appropriate issues thing for the open closed hearing. Are there going to be more than one hearing on that?
No. For the Department of Health?
Yeah.
Yeah, no. So we don't have to have three of them.
Just one hearing?
Yeah.
Today?
Yeah, today.
Well, you had one a few weeks ago.
Yeah, we had one a few weeks ago. We don't have.
So this will be our second.
Yeah.
I was just wondering about that.
No, we're not required to have three, right?
No, resolution.
So.
So any comments concerning that or during the public hearing?
Yeah, I can open it up for.
Not now.
You can speak now if you like, but I'll open it up then.
Speak forever, hold your peace, man.
Talk about you some Sunday when I preach.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a promise.
No, they can go today. It's on the.
So that adds another.
Yes.
Well, it's a good 40 minutes. Deal.
We're all Wilson from Dizer. We're all Wilson from Dizer. I was just wondering, you don't actually have the vote for the decrease of public health on your agenda date. You only have a public hearing. So will that be on next week then? And the resolution that's been pre-written will be for next week? Or is there something that I'm missing that you guys can still vote even though it's not listed on the agenda? It just says public hearing.
Yeah.
Probably should
the
be.
Result of the public hearing is the vote.
Yeah.
Like any other public hearing.
And I just, we mentioned it before in other meetings, but I do find it out that the resolution is already printed out like a foregone conclusion before we've even had the public hearing to hear comments that you guys will be appropriating the money when we haven't even had the public hearing today. So it just feels like you've already had your mind made up and anything we say is not going to matter at all, which we've felt that way a lot, but just having it printed out that you already decided this resolution and it doesn't, you know, specifically say you're voting today, it just feels like you're
pushing it through and not listening to citizens' comments before you make up your mind. Thank you.
So I want to comment on this. Why is it printed and are you guys done? Made up your mind already? Or did you guys have a special meeting that we don't know about and decided? Because this is hurtful. You promised me last time that you were going to do research and really consider it, so all of a sudden your mind's made up?
We will be taking a vote, yes.
Why is this printed then? That's my question. Why is the resolution already printed?
Because we have to vote on a resolution.
So why is it already saying it's you're taking it out? You've like made up your mind.
It'll be the outcome of the vote.
You're not answering my question. Why is this printed if it's already saying it's taking it out? That's my question. Why is it printed?
Because we have everything printed so we can vote on it. Okay?
Yeah. You're missing my point.
Shouldn't the resolution be passed after the vote?
Yes. That was my point.
I think we put the cart before the horse here.
They have to have something to vote on, so I wrote that up based on what might be happening. I could write it the other way and put that on there also, and then they could all vote.
Well, that's the way it should have been done. It should have had both options on it. Because this makes it sound very final.
That's just a version of what could be passed or not passed. We have to have something in writing.
So why isn't both on it? Could be passed, because this could be passed or the other one could be passed.
The last time we had the public hearing, mm-hmm. also, we had that same resolution wrote up
okay.
the same way, and they tabled it. So, it's not that they have to do that.
Okay.
It's just something to start with.
That's fine. That's why I was asking questions, because when she
yes.
said it, you didn't get that answer. So that's my question.
I believe we get them for everything, don't we?
Yeah, there's always something written up.
That's my question. Both of you guys a million times.
Yeah.
Come in, you probably don't know the Pythagorean theorem, but I'm going to explain it to you, so I'm asking you a question.
Yeah, no, I think that's...
Yeah, we have to have something to vote on, so that can be changed, it can be tabled, it can be...
Well, if we do the right thing, it should be changed.
That might happen, yeah.
So do you need something in writing if you don't appropriate these funds since you've already passed it?
I don't believe so. I think
it's already been appropriated back in June.
Okay, so you don't need anything. So
right.
this
no.
could be null and void.
Right,
absolutely.
It very well could be.
That's the way it should be.
Yep.
So I'm here as the county sanitarian. Should I be speaking now during the public opinions, or should I wait to give the information that I'd like to put forth to the board during the 10 o'clock time slot?
You've got 2 minutes.
Yeah, a couple minutes.
2 to 3 minutes. I think he's just waiting. I mean,
Said I'm here as a county employee, as a
for the hearing.
For the hearing, correct. So
I'm talking hearing.
That's what I assumed as well.
I would
take myself to 2 minutes.
Yeah, I'd wait.
There's no time limit during the public hearing, is it?
No.
There is.
Oh, I thought there was. Well,
okay.
You're
here all day.
Public comment. We're not going to be here all day, I'll guarantee you.
He's flying out tonight. He's got to go. We'll give you an hour.
I don't think so. For more than an hour.
We're
not going to do an hour.
Okay, we'll give you 5 minutes. How's that?
Short and sweet.
Short and sweet, yeah.
Short and sweet.
Not taking me with him, so whatever.
No.
But my kids helped with that, so. Also need to get cut. When it's cut, you can't see as many.
Call the meeting to order. And I have a motion to approve last week's minutes.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second. Been moved and seconded to approve last week's minutes. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Ben?
Morning.
Morning, Ben. Morning, Ben, how are you?
Doing great. Got pretty much kinda similar things going on this week. Got some rig raids. 270th will be rocking this week. Finishing that out, and then digging some ditch, and then hopefully be rocking that as well this week as well. Toledo Bridge, they're going to be placing a rebar this week. They were hoping to pour concrete this Friday, but we told them that would be really bad. Not really bad, but highly advised against. So hot. Next week looks like a lot better week to place concrete. So it's looking like they'll be doing the deck or placing the deck next week. Our bridge crew is up on M Avenue and putting some tanker cars in there. Some rusted out culvert pipe we had. Shop has come along. So the product that Minax suggested to place on the floor will be here midweek this week. And I know Kurt, we plan on Tuesday. We can kind of look at that, look at the product. Urbana, I'll pick you up.
Buying lunch food, by the way.
Oh, okay. Sounds good. I can do that. We'll be selling some equipment on site called Gov Deals. The DOT, Iowa DOT does that. And it's pretty much, we don't have to pay like an auction fee. So it's like we get all, you know, if it sold for X amount of dollars, we get X amount of dollars. We don't have to, the seller pays the auction fee. So
a lot, or you know,
example
of a couple?
We got that Dodge Intrepid. That we had, it was more kind of an office car, and it's not going to be really all that much use, and then probably get a few kind of parts, trucks that aren't really,
So no maintainers or
maintainers, anything like that, it's just kind of,
trucks,
just well, maybe one truck, and then I think a few. Forklift that we already have a forklift, and it's we've tried to sell it in the past and haven't sold it, so I don't know, just trying to get housekeeping items that we have that we can kind of get rid of. So
okay, I was looking, we signed or we looked at the money we spent last week, that pressure grout up on the V37.
Yes.
Are we getting reimbursed for that, or why are we paying for that? Do you know, or can you find out?
I guess I can.
It was like $6,000 something.
I think that one was for, that wasn't for the V37. That was the T55.
Oh. Okay.
Because we had done a T55. We did one.
It worked.
And it worked very well, so.
It worked great on V37. I mean.
Oh, the stuff they did there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Same thing, I would guess.
Yeah, it was the same crew.
Okay, so that's.
But right. we'll probably be getting a bill for half of it, since that's Benton County. Benton County kind of set it up, and they'll probably pay for it, send us a bill for half, since we kind of share maintenance on that road. So.
It was a good thing.
Yeah.
A lot of complaints about it.
No, I know. But yeah. It was.
What's your plans on using the ground up asphalt the pile there, that stockpile there, what's the plans on that?
I'm not quite sure.
That was a Lyle thing, so I don't know if he, did he tell you?
Because every year, SS, it seeps the oil, you know, out of it, doesn't make it as well, so.
Yeah.
Buildings are usually on the shoulders of the black.
Yeah, or he.
I know that they, from when I was talking with him this morning, that they use some of it for, I think, Glad Rook, maybe, possibly, for that road up there.
Yeah, they're gonna put it on some sort of road too, I thought.
So, I'm getting used to figuring out where these different piles of rock and asphalt are, so.
Well, I believe the road going to the Otter Creek Lake, that was made out of new ground asphalt.
Yeah.
And, maybe Ian Grove could use it there too, you know?
Lyle, I can tell you really for sure, Lyle had the plan, but I don't, obviously he didn't tell the new guy. I mean, that's all I can say, right?
Yeah, I'm not sure.
It's a pretty good pile.
Yeah.
I have a question too. We have a new grader on our road.
Yeah.
We had Craig Cohen check, and we have somebody else. Our road is getting narrower and narrower, you know, and I'm thinking that the, doesn't know exactly, because it's at least 2 foot narrower. My kids are coming down going, you only have a lane and a half now, because he's not grading it out. There's so much vegetation on each side.
What road?
It's in Geneseo Township, the gravel road, 140th, but it's probably all of them.
Yeah.
And I just think it's the grader. I'm not blaming him. I just think that maybe check into that, because.
Okay.
Geneseo.
You know, all the gravel roads are that way.
You think they're worse? Well, but Craig Cohen, he didn't really had good.
Yeah,
he had it good.
You were very spoiled. He was
top notch.
He was one of the best we had.
Yeah.
You were, but.
But it should be.
As long as. I mean, the vegetation is something we can take care of. I guess one of my things, working for them so long, I didn't like them cutting, which is taking dirt, you know, a little bit of dirt, to basically mow that grass off. Because when they do that, you have 4 foot of mud. You know, then you got then your middle's good, and then you got a ridge. I think I said something to you about it too, but if there's something we can do about the vegetation, the road's still there. It just, you got grass on it, on both sides.
Yeah, you have to more, you know, if you meet two cars, I don't even know if you can meet there anymore. I mean, you can.
Yeah.
It's just, it's wide, but it's.
Yeah, you just have to drive on some grass.
Yeah.
Well, you can't get to the grass because the grader rolls there.
Yeah.
The ridge?
I got a 60-inch deck. I can't mow the grass
Right. Me neither.
So there's 5 foot, 6 foot on either side of the road they're not using. And then they put their grader roll there, a foot away from the grass, so then you cut the road down more, and they got such a crown on the road. I bet there's a foot crown on a lot of these roads.
Well,
you go on a tractor, wagon, straight truck, whatever, loaded with grain, you're tipped so much, you almost feel like you're going to flop over.
Some roads,
I can see
that,
and they got a grade there, fine, I see the idea, get the water off. But then you get to the edge of the road, they got a 3-inch lip of grass. The water can't get to the ditch. So it runs down the side of the road and makes its own ditch. So if they got to either level the roads up, get that edge off the edge of the road, so the water can get away.
Yeah.
And like you say, it's all dirt. What do you do with it?
Yeah,
you gotta get in the middle of the road and make a mud road.
Yeah,
they're so worried about that crown that they're staying away from the dirt, and they're making the edges worse.
Yeah.
I don't know what you can do about it. I'm not an expert, but
Well, I always said the, my, I mean, I'm not, I'd like to, without that edge there, without them cutting, I mean, they'll leave a edge, dirt and grass, that's not good.
No.
But I don't mind if it's that way and there's no edge, you know what I mean? If the water can get off.
But what do you do with that dirt? Push it in the ditch, well then you fill it in the ditch.
Well, you're pretty much, that's what you're gonna do with it, not, and then.
I don't know.
Yeah, that's what it's gonna be.
But I mean, that's why there's getting to be so much grass there, they don't wanna get that dirt. And they're building the center up so high.
Yeah.
That they got this mess out on the end. I don't know what to do, what you would do with it. The caution arm lake takes on a machine and dig the dirt up.
Yeah.
And dump it up.
Push it in the dirt.
And then you just push it in the ditch, you know, then you defeat your purpose of the ditch.
Yeah.
You guys are caught between a rock and a hard spot.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I always liked the idea. I mean, I thought some of them, or quite a few of them were getting too wide. And it's hard to take care of them when you do that. You know, like you have to, you can't have gravel roads where you got to take two rounds, you know, put one here and put one there, because it's just time consuming. I mean, it's tough to get rock there anyway. We only have four haulers and then some spares, so.
After contract rock.
But you're right. It's a rock and a hard place. I'm not going to argue that at all. I think I know what you're talking about, and it's not a good situation either. But I'd like to see them not cut wider roads. I mean, just so we can get more better rock coverage. But when you have a lip there and the rock and the water stays on there and runs down, that's not a good thing either.
Usually shoot for like 26 foot for width of the road.
Yep.
So okay. Well, I
you'll be surprised.
Yeah.
I
didn't
think
yeah.
so.
And what was that website that you're gonna put?
GovDeals. If you typed in, I think, the Tama County in the search bar, it kind of come up.
Okay.
Because we'd have her.
Tom wants.
I think we're planning on. On our website, I think on our Facebook, and then on our website, we'll put like a link. We might have stuff available to sell, and then we might not, but it'll be there. So as a link to anybody that wants to purchase anything up there. So
Tom needs a maintainer or something.
Yeah, I think so.
Sit around bother you.
Hey, thank you, Ben.
Thanks, Ben. We'll see you tomorrow.
Yep. I'll get with you.
All right.
Okay.
Anything about HR?
I think you just have the...
We have a 2080 agreement.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
There was a typo in the actual resolution, which I've corrected on these two copies. I just had an and in there too many times.
And.
Okay, would you like to read that?
Yeah, so right now on the agenda is a proposed resolution for a 28E agreement with Marshall County. Resolution 821-2023A, a resolution to enter into a 28E agreement to share zoning and weed commissioner operations and costs. Whereas the Marshall County Board of Supervisors have approved a 28E agreement to share zoning and weed commission with Tama County, and whereas the Tama County Board of Supervisors are interested in sharing these positions also, therefore be it resolved that the Tama County Board of Supervisors hereby approves the 28E agreement to share zoning and weed commissioner operations and costs.
Okay. I have a motion to...
I make the motion to approve resolution 8-21-2023A.
I'll second that motion.
Good. Moved and seconded. Roll call vote.
Kurt?
Aye.
Bill?
Aye.
Dan?
Aye.
Okay.
Thank you. Resolution passed.
I have a question. Have you guys set the percentage of how much you'll be covering that cost with Marshall County yet, or is that
60-40?
60-40.
Marshall.
Thank you.
That all? Okay. I have 9:45. We'll have a public hearing on a precinct redistricting. Would you like to say anything, Richard, since you're on that committee, or?
I know. Do you want me to stand up, or can I just speak?
You just sit there.
Speak there.
Basically, three of us got together. Mike Wensing, Joe Ball, and myself. The auditor's office had done a very good job of trying to set up the new five-person supervisor district and while maintaining the current 13 voting precincts. Trying to, so we don't have any more voting districts, precincts than necessary because of the cost and the people available to do the work. So I thank the auditor's office for all their hard work. I think we did a good job of setting up the districts for supervisors while maintaining the population equal, approximately 3,500 in each five districts. So thanks to the auditor's office, and if there's any questions I can try and answer, I will.
Okay, thank you, Ricky. See any? Do we need a motion to go to?
So then you, if you're done with public comments, then we can close the public comment part of it.
Okay, we'll close public comment.
Yep. Then you did it, just need a motion and a second to approve this first hearing. Also, I want to point out that what we're setting are the actual voting precincts, not the supervisor districts. We had to kind of, the state does that. We kind of had to make that work, and then we'll share that with the state, and hopefully they'll approve what we are proposing for supervisor districts.
We're making a recommendation to the state.
Yes.
We hope it is actually the state's responsibility to set up the supervisor districts, but because Laura was able to come up with these figures, it would be a lot easier for the state to just look at it and say, well, the population is the same. Let's go with it. So that's my hope. But if they want to change it, it is their responsibility. So.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. I guess I'll make that motion. That'd be accepted.
Yeah, I'll second it first. Okay, been moved and seconded to accept the second reading. Precinct redistricting. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Okay, claims. I have a
I'll make a motion to approve the claims.
I'll second that.
Claims this week are $474,251.06.
They're moved and seconded to approve them. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Urban Renewal Report for fiscal year 2023.
And that is something I put on the agenda as the auditor. I'm in charge of preparing an annual Urban Renewal Report. This is for the Vienna Wind Farm Urban Renewal Area. So every year we have, the supervisors have put that in a TIF area so they can capture the taxes above a certain level of value. And this year, the amount that we had in reserves was $205,835. The amount of TIF revenue was $408,555. Property tax replacement claims was $17,781 for a total of $426,336. The payment this year was $492,083. So that's less than what we owed. So then as a result of that, we've had to levy through a debt service levy. And this year they, to make that payment complete, they levied $121,693 to make that full payment. After that that payment this year, the amount left owed is $5,271,839.
Okay, 120. I have 100. What's this 140 temp?
That's how much is left in the debt service.
Okay.
Yep. So that'll be at the top next year for that 205.
Nice. Yeah. Okay.
Can I have a motion to approve the urban renewal report?
I'll make that motion.
I'll second. Been moved and seconded to approve the annual urban renewal report. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Okay, next is authorized treasurer on the conservation holding account.
I don't know if she wants to come down for that or not.
Let me see, we're just four.
When we go to the next one, we reach the 6 months.
Yeah, we can.
We'll go ahead with Allegiance 6.
Okay, sure.
Come on up, Marty.
I'll go get her, Laura.
Okay.
So, I'm with Region 6. We have partners out of Marshalltown. We had anybody come before the different four county board of supervisors to request financial help to apply for State of Iowa funding for the Housing Trust Fund program. So this year we can apply for $415,865 if we have a match of $95,649. Historically, we've shared the local match across the four counties on a per capita basis. So the match amount for Tama County would be $17,665. That amount is up a little bit from last year because the amount of money in the state fund keeps increasing a little bit. Likewise, they're ratcheting up the local match share a little bit. That's a little less than 25%. Historically, it was at the 25% level. And then the last 2 years, they've decreased that. So from 2015 through 2022, the program has spent $385,000 here in Tama County, which is roughly $50,000 less than the per capita level for the region. We do have several big projects we're looking at in downtown Toledo to store upper levels of buildings into apartments. We have two different projects we're looking at that way. We normally do just homeowner rehabilitation repairs, so we're talking exterior repairs. Roof, siding, and windows would be our typical items that we do. We were helpful with derecho repairs and tornado repairs happened here historically. All the recipients have to be income qualified, so they have to be under incomes of roughly $40,000 a year. We have priority cases that are under roughly $15,000 a year that are priority cases for us, and we're always seeking applicants from those priority groups under roughly $15,000 a year. We generally don't do for-profit rental projects unless they have some long-term financing that requires long-term benefit to lower-income families. So those would be generally the low-income housing tax credit kind of projects that are pretty common in certain areas. I guess Tama's Leo hasn't had one of those projects for 10 to 15 years here. I guess if you have any questions, I can help address them at this time. $17,000 would be the support for the new app, and that would be coming from your next fiscal year budget. So.
Okay. I'll make motion that we approve resolution 2021-2023C to approve Region 6 Housing Trust Fund.
I'll second that.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded to approve the Region 6 Housing Trust Fund. I'll have a roll call vote.
Okay, Kurt?
Aye.
Bill?
Aye.
Dan?
Aye.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. What do you want?
Would like to be added to Conservation's merchant account. It's like a credit card clearing account. It has not been something that's been in our bank recs. Probably should be. Also not in an interest-bearing account. That's all I got. I think it should be part of our normal bank rec process.
Okay.
It would be like our landfill. We have a landfill account that's for card purchases. This is the same thing. Also, public health has a, they're kind of clearing accounts, so the money goes there and they sweep to interest-bearing accounts.
Okay.
So are you talking about taking more funds again from the State Bank of Toledo and putting them into?
That's not at all what I said.
Okay. I'm asking that.
Yeah, no.
Okay. Can I have a motion to approve the treasurer? Or authorized treasurer on the conservation holding account.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second it.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded to authorize treasurer on conservation holding account. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.
Thank you.
Got it, Donna. Okay, we have time. We need to reappoint Pete Eichamp to the Civil Service Commission.
You talked to him like
that? I have talked to Pete. He's willing to do it again, so you need a motion?
Yes.
I'll make that motion to accept Pete Eichamp back for our commission.
I will second that. Okay, it's been moved and seconded to reappoint Pete Eichamp to the Civil Service Commission. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Okay. Annual LAD account.
Hey, that was me again. So at the end of June every year, the conservation director comes and asks you to approve the annual LAD land acquisition and development. That's a special account he has. And normally every year, whatever's left in his budget gets transferred to that special fund to use for developing at the county lake. So you guys approve that in June, and it's always pending all of his claims coming in and any camping. So I talked to Stephen about this a couple weeks ago, and he's not able to be here, so I went over it again, and it looks like the amount left, because there was quite a bit left in the capital improvements, which is for the lake restoration. The amount I show is $330,000. So you guys have already approved this. I just wanted you to be aware of the amount of it. So this was just for information only. It was approved back on June 26th, but I'm just letting you know the amount. Since it's a large amount, usually it's not that large, and why it was larger. So, I think it was over $195,000 was left over from that.
Okay.
Building line item. So.
Well, that's one we don't need a vote or anything.
No, because you've already voted on it. I just wanted to know the amount since it was large.
Thank you, Laura.
Yep.
Thank you, Laura. Yeah, I got it. So. Okay, redistricting.
He's working already.
What's his name again?
Tavius Stevens.
Tavius Stevens. Is he from Marshall County?
LeGrand.